Hi, and welcome to part 3. We're now at the final stage of this process in which we combine our video file with our mixed audio file from the TouchMix and render a final export for online distribution. The first step here is to connect the hard drive to your computer. Open the session folder and then the exports folder. Copy the WAV or MP3 file, whichever you want to use, to your computer hard drive. The WAV file is higher quality, but has a larger file size. In general, it's best to use the highest quality file possible to begin with, so we're going to use the WAV file for this demonstration. If need be, the file can be converted to a smaller file after the initial export. Now I'm going to show you 3 ways to replace the audio recorded by your smartphone with your TouchMix stereo mix using different video editing software. The first method will be using Adobe Premiere Pro. The first step is to create a new project, then add the phone video and the WAV mix to your media library. Next, add your video file into a new sequence and your WAV below the video track. Hold the Shift key down and select the phone audio and the WAV so they are both selected. Then right-click and select Synchronize. Then click Audio, then OK. Your WAV mix is now synchronized with your phone audio. Now mute the phone audio channel and adjust master volume of your WAV so that it is in the yellow but not clipping. The last step is to trim your audio and video. Set your start and end points for the video and then export or render your video for whatever destination you want to use it for. Click File, Export Media. This will bring up the export dialog box. Here you can name your file, set a save location, and choose what quality we want the file to be. For this example, we'll select the YouTube export preset that Premiere already has. Next, we'll look at this same process using iMovie. In iMovie, it's similar, but you will need to synchronize your audio manually. Drag the 2 files into your iMovie project. Add the video to your timeline and then the TouchMix WAV below it. Drag your TouchMix file so that it lines up with the audio file on your phone. This is where the 3 claps come in handy. When you get it pretty close, you can zoom in and get it lined up exactly. Once it's lined up, we'll need to remove the camera audio. We can do this by clicking the volume bar within the file timeline and drag it all the way down. Now we can set our beginning and end points and export it as a new file. Click File, Share, File. This will pull up the video export dialog box in which we can name the video and select the save location on your computer. You can also select the resolution size of the video. For the last method, we'll look at how to do this using Logic Pro. I know, Logic is not a video editing software, it's a DAW. But Logic does have the ability to import video, so you can use this for the purposes of syncing audio and video. This is very similar to what we did in iMovie. First, create a new session in Logic and create a new audio track. Now import the mixed audio file from the TouchMix. You can do this by selecting File, Import, Audio, and then locate your file using the Finder window. Or you can open a Finder window yourself, locate the file, and simply click and drag the file into your Logic session. Now that we have our audio file in the session, let's import the video by clicking File, Movie, Open Movie. Locate the video and click Open. Upon importing the video file, you will be presented with a dialog box with the options to open the movie and to extract the audio track. You want to leave both of these boxes checked. You may also receive a dialog box indicating that there is a frame rate mismatch between the Logic session and the video file. If you get this notification, always choose the option to change the Logic session to match the video frame rate. Changing the video frame rate can cause problems. Now Logic will open the video in a new window, and the audio from the video will be placed on a new track in the session. You can close the video window and Logic will reduce it to a thumbnail in the upper left-hand corner of the session. If you ever want to expand it again, all you have to do is double-click the thumbnail. Or if you have more than one screen, you can move the video window onto another screen. Now we have our 2 audio tracks in Logic. Now we can manually synchronize these much the same way we did in iMovie. Again, we're going to use our claps as a reference point. We can line those up and then zoom in further to line them up as closely as possible. Now that we have them synced up, you can either mute the smartphone camera audio track or delete it altogether. Now, we'll use the cycle mode to select our beginning and end points for the final render. Click and drag in the small area just above the top of the cursor in the timeline. As you drag, a yellow bar will appear. Use this bar to set the beginning and end of the video. To export your new video file, click File, Movie, Export Audio to Movie. This will bring up the file export dialog box in which you can name the file and set the save location, as well as select the audio format, sample rate, and bit depth. For this example, we'll use linear PCM as the format with a sample rate of 44.1K because that is the original sample rate of the recorded audio, and a bit depth of 24. A higher bit rate results in a higher quality file. Once you hit save, you will be presented with a second dialog box. This is a bit confusing. This dialog box is asking which tracks to export and will only give you the option of the original audio track from the video. You do not want this. We want to select the new track that we imported and lined up. This is not presented as an option, however. What you need to do is uncheck the box indicating the original audio file. This tells Logic not to use the original audio and instead to use whatever additional audio is available. I know, like I said, a bit confusing. Honestly, I don't even know why they have that option. One caveat to using Logic is that it will only export video as QuickTime video files, or .mov files. For most applications, this shouldn't be a problem, but if the platform you intend to upload your video onto does not accept .mov files, you'll need to convert the file using video editing software after all. Here's a quick comparison between the audio from the phone and the audio recorded and mixed on the TouchMix. So that's an easy and efficient way to make high-quality live performance video productions using audio from your TouchMix and video from your smartphone. Hopefully this was helpful. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.